Well, hello. As we get more into the season of games and big game days, it's great to have something that you can put together and feed a lot of people, but be really delicious and have a lot of heartiness to it. And that's what these sheet pan nachos are all about. Because they're not just sheet pan nachos. They are pulled pork sheet pan nachos, carnita style, and it's really delicious. And we're gonna do it all in the slow cooker to get the pork ready. Put it together on a big sheet pan with tortilla chips and cheese and toppings, and it's gonna be really delicious and make everyone say, what game? Let's just eat nachos. That's what matters. So to start, we're gonna do a quick spice rub, which is gonna go on the pork and then slow cook until it just falls apart, pulls apart exactly as you want. So I'm gonna put some smoked paprika. Now, if you follow me, you know I have a love for smoked paprika because it has no heat, but it has a lot of smoky flavor, and that makes it feel like a meat has been sitting for a long time on a smoker or doing all those things and getting all that flavor. We're gonna put in cumin, and I have just enough cumin left in this container, so I'm gonna put it right in there. And the cumin has that nice earthy kind of warm spice to it. It's really delicious. We're gonna do some Mexican oregano. If you can't find Mexican, you can do just traditional oregano, like a Greek or an Italian, but Mexican oregano has something special. And it really does just give it even more flavor. I like to sometimes rub it between my hands just to break it up even more, get those essential oils really activated. Some chili powder. I think chili powder is just a good base when you wanna amp up those flavors for a nacho style flavor. The chili powder has already the cumin in it. It has some paprika, but it also has, you know, kind of that warmth to it that you want. And these then just amp that up. Of course, we need salt too. Meat needs salt. It's one of the most important things I feel like for meat. And it's what's gonna actually bring out flavor and retain moisture. So we're gonna sit and stir this, a really quick spice rub. And you can see, look at all those colors, look at all the flavor. If you smell it, it smells delicious and almost nacho-like, or nachos that I want, I should say. So once that's mixed up, we have our shoulder roast. This is a pork shoulder roast, which means it has a lot of fat running throughout it. So it's gonna really be good at slow cooking and it all melts out and it just becomes tender and falls apart. But sometimes they come with a big fat cap on top. That I don't need. So I have been cutting that off with a sharp knife. The thing when you have a big fat cap on top, sometimes for long smoking times, it will actually be in, you know, kind of important, but when we're doing a slow cooker, fat caps just tend to make a lot of fat sit in the slow cooker. This still has a lot of fat running throughout it, a lot of ribbons of fat. So I'm not gonna worry too much about taking that fat cap off. So here's our meat. We're gonna take our spice rub and we're just gonna slowly start putting it on the meat. We're gonna kind of rub it in. Look how instantly you're getting that beautiful color. You're getting that beautiful, just instant kind of smoky meat, like you're ready to put it on for a long cook. But this isn't gonna involve a smoker, although you could do it on a smoker. That would add even more flavor, but we're doing it easy. We're doing it in a crock pot. You can do it in your kitchen. That slow cooker can just sit in there, can make your house smell amazing. You wanna get it on all sides. And what we're doing is one, seasoning it with the salt, but we're making sure all those spices get around too. And if there, you know what, if it opens up like that, put it all around, make sure you get it all around there. So I'm gonna put on the spices, and then all we do, this is the easy part, we're gonna put it in our slow cooker. And any residual spices, make sure they get on there. We're gonna put it right in, and I'm gonna dump in any of those spices. Look at that. Now, I am always prepared and have hot soapy water in my sink. So I wash my hands to get the meat off. I put it in the hot soapy water, rub them around, make sure to scrub them. When you're working with meat, you just wanna be prepared. And then it's easier to come back and keep going. So to this, I'm gonna do two things. I'm gonna add some tomato sauce. That's gonna really create like a sauce with the meat, which is what I wanna do. I'm gonna put it right in there, right on top, which as it cooks, it's really going to meld with the juices of the meat. It's gonna really mix together. Then also some orange. Orange is that like bright acidic flavor that's gonna really make it kind of pop and really give it something special. So these are oranges. We know when we get into the winter seasons, it's actually the season for citrus. So you get a lot of extra good citrus in the stores. So I'm gonna put that orange juice right on top too. And what's nice about orange, it surprisingly actually works really well with chili flavors, with cumin. It really just kind of wakes everything up. And that's what I love. So now that I have all this in here, this is the first part and the hardest part of these nachos. I'm gonna put the lid on, I'm gonna turn it on, and we're gonna let it cook until it just falls apart with a fork, slowly and easily. That's the best part of a slow cooker, is that you don't really have to do anything. You just have to set it. I feel like an infomercial and forget it. So that's what we're gonna do. A little bit ago, I took the roast out of the crock pot because I checked with a fork, I knew the time, and it was done. So my crock pot, you have to set for like so many hours, way more than usually you need. But then I take it out when it's done, and you can see what I've been doing is just shredding it. And look how easy and fall apart it just shreds. This is, look at that. It's like the perfect just pull, fall apart pork. What's great is you can do really anything with this pork you want to, and it will make more probably, unless you're having a massive crowd. Most likely you'll have leftovers. So you can put it back in the juice, the leftovers, and you can use it for sandwiches or tacos or more nachos, because nachos should be in our future all the time. So since I have some of the meat shredded, I put out some chips onto a baking sheet, have it lined with parchment. And what I'm gonna do at this point is just take pieces of meat and put it around. We're kind of gonna build our own nachos and just make it somewhat more fun. Because the thing is, when you're having a crowd over, say you're having people over, say you just have a big family, maybe you're not having a party this year, and you just wanna have something fun, this is a great way to do it because it puts all the work already on a baking sheet. So you don't have to do all those individual plates and have them built. Instead, you can just have plates that people then pull the nachos off that they want, and you can kind of pick and choose. And look at this. You're just building, to me, this like great nacho. And I just pulled this apart in kind of bite-sized pieces, but big enough that people can see what's going on, because that's what I want here. I want people to see what we're doing, because the pulled pork here, it has like Southwestern vibes, but it's the star of the show. It's what you want people to see and what you want them to notice, because it's gonna have a great flavor impact. All the ingredients we put on it, even the tomato sauce, even though it's not having a major player here, it's doing lots of flavor into the pork. So at this point then, before I put this into the oven, I'm gonna build on, do it a little bit with some drained, rinsed and drained beans, black beans. You could do any bean. You know, the thing with nachos, they're customizable. Do what you like, but this is what I love to do. I like, they add that creaminess, they add great texture. You know, that's just kind of what you want. You wanna eat with your eyes, with your mouth, you wanna see it, and just know it's gonna be delicious. So I'm gonna spread those around. Already, this looks great. And then cheese. So we've shredded cheese. If you don't like the cheese I'm doing, do whatever cheese you do like. What I always think the important part is here, not to overdo the cheese, because we're gonna have a lot of other components that people can dip and top and take. So I'm gonna put the cheese on, make sure to cover most of the pieces, but then once it melts, it even covers more surface area. So I'm gonna put this into the oven. I have it going. We're gonna let that melt up, and then we can talk about toppings and we can finish these off, and I can check them. I'm just gonna check them to make sure they're delicious. I just took them out of the oven. It takes a couple minutes. It's not long at all. And you can see it just melts the cheese, which what's great is you can make this your own. Put as much cheese or as little as you want on top. After I finish shredding all the meat, I just for now put it back into the liquid so it just sits and absorbs all that, stays moist. You could use it on next batches. You could use it on whatever you want. But if you don't want it to get wet and be soppy on chips, I would just leave it out until you want to use it. Now you can just top it with anything and everything you love. That's the best part. I think it always needs some pico de gallo. So this you can make homemade, you can make fresh. I like to have it drained if you're gonna put it on top like this, because then you're not getting all that extra liquid. You could serve salsa also just on the side so people can dip their own. These obviously I'm just gonna dress more how I would dress them. And then you could do whatever you want to at home. What I think is the best part sometimes is the topping. So I love sliced radish because it has that cooling effect and it gives it crunch. So that's why a lot of times you'll see these with certain tacos and you'll see this like delicious kind of crunchy that gives you that slight sweet, but more of like that weird, interesting kind of note of a spice almost, which I think is just like delicious. If you follow me during gardening season, you know, I grow lots of radishes because I love them. So I use them all throughout the year if I can find them when they start coming in. So with this, you can also add some maybe chopped red onion, just a little bit to give it kind of a fresh, what I like about red onion, it's a little bit sweeter, a little bit less astringent or strong. So it gives it that oniony flavor without just too much. I think it needs some fresh cilantro on top. I do. I know if you don't like cilantro, don't do it. Or if it tastes like soap, obviously don't do it. Yes, some people have a gene and it makes it taste like soap to them. I totally get that. You could put some fresh, kind of just crumbled up cotija cheese, which is like a Mexican version of a Parmesan. It's aged, it's a harder cheese, but it gives you that fresh hit at the end, which I like. And it adds that great color, but it's all about the textures and the layers of flavor to me. And then I did quick pickle, just some jalapenos, so you can have some of those on there. just, you know, whatever you love. There's really no right or wrong, and that's the best part. I mean, look, guys, look at this. Like, okay, if anything is gonna get me to go to a football party, it's this right here. You can serve avocado on the side. That's what I love, like right here, look at this. You get those delicious, beautiful, ripe avocados. If you want to, and you know everyone loves it, put it on top. If they, you don't know, put some on the side and just let people take it if they want it. That's kind of the best part, and you're gonna have, you're gonna please everyone and make something beautiful. That is the whole point. So, let me find one that I really want. I'm gonna pull on a piece of meat. I'm gonna pull on a jalapeno. That's a good chip right there. If it was my choosing, I'd have avocado yet, but I'll stop here. Mmm. Mm-hmm. I'm happy. Bring on the football. You know what? What I love is all the layers of flavor here. You got great tortilla chips. You get that soft pull-apart meat that has a ton of flavor with the spices we put on it. You get the crunch of a radish if you get it. I got a pickled jalapeno on there, and that was a great level of spice to add on top. A little bit of cotija, the melted cheese we put on top. The beans are so good. Avocado would have made me happier, but that's okay. I'll have some later. Guys, this is delicious. And what I love is everyone is gonna be happy. Look at these beautiful things. They have something for everyone. You know what? Make a pan for kids, make a pan for adults, make a pan for the spice lover, one for the mild lover, whatever it is, you can do it right here. And the star of the show, the pulled pork. It's so good and you can use it in so many ways. You're gonna have leftovers most likely. Actually, I shouldn't say that. You may not, it's so good. But if you do, you're gonna be using it all week long. Imagine a salad with like this idea. Yeah, I like that. So what do I hope you do? I hope you make nachos. I hope you make sheet pan nachos with pulled pork because it's so good. I hope you share this video around so everyone can see if this guy can do it. Anyone can do it. It's fun, it's easy, it's delicious. It's a great way to have a party. It's a great way to entertain and just enjoy yourself. Pull everyone in and have them make them. Until next time, check my website, wiseguy.com, for this recipe. All of my other recipes, they're on there. Have some nachos, enjoy it. Hope your team wins.